In the previous video, I had explained the formation and properties of steam. We had come up to this point. We had come to the fifth point, that is the different states of steam: wet steam, dry steam, and superheated steam. And I had told you what are the differences between this, and I had explained you this formation of steam with the help of TH diagram. Now we will continue further. Further, it is. I told you that the sixth item that we have to know is the dryness fraction. Dryness fraction or quality of wet steam. It is also called as quality of wet steam. Quality of wet steam or dryness fraction. See, I told you what wet steam is. Wet steam means if I stop giving heat anywhere between these two, I have crossed A, I have given sensible heat fully, but I have not given the latent heat fully. The steam has not absorbed latent heat fully. So if I stop somewhere here, then the steam that I get is wet steam. Now if you simply say wet steam, if we simply say wet steam, we will not be able to understand exactly where we have stopped. Here also it is wet, here also it is wet, here also it is wet. So if you simply say, it becomes a general term. If you say wet steam, we do not know where it is. So to give its exact location, where exactly we have stopped, we have to express this dryness fraction. We have to give the dryness fraction. Whenever there is a problem on wet steam, we have to give the dryness fraction of wet steam. So first we must know what is the meaning of dryness fraction. Now this dryness fraction is denoted by X, or in some books it is also denoted by Q, small q. This is defined as a ratio of mass of dry steam. Mass of dry steam in a given sample of wet steam. Mass of, you see, wet steam means it's a mixture of dry saturated steam and moisture or water or vapor, this water particles. So mass of dry steam in a given sample, in a given wet steam sample divided by mass of dry steam in a given wet steam sample to mass of wet steam sample, that is complete wet steam sample. This ratio is known as dryness fraction or quality of wet steam. It can be given as either, it will be given like this, 0.94, or it can be given as 94% dry. They can say it is 0.94 dry, or they can also call it as 94% dry. It can be given either as a decimal or as in percentage. Now what it means is, if I say it is 90.94 dry or 94% dry, that means it has taken 94% of the latent heat. It has not taken 100% of latent heat. When it takes 100% of latent heat, it becomes dry saturated, but it has taken only 94%. Even if it has taken 99% of the latent heat, it is called as the wet steam only. Now this means 1 kg steam, wet steam, which is 94% dry, is a mixture of 940 grams of dry steam and 60 grams of water or moisture. If you take 0.5 kg sample of 94% dry steam, it has how much? 570 grams of dry steam plus 30 grams of water. Sorry, this is 470. 470 grams of dry steam and 30 grams of water. If you take quarter kg of this, it has 235 grams of dry steam in it and remaining 15 grams is water or moisture. Now, you see, dryness fraction will be 940. Mathematically, it will be 940 plus 60 divided by 1000 grams. 940 grams plus 60 grams, that is 1000. 940 divided by, this should be 940 divided by 940 plus 60. This will give you 0.94, or 90. If you multiply it by 100, it becomes 94%. If you take this sample, 470 plus 30, again this will give you 0.94. If you take that sample, quarter kg, you divide 235 plus 15, you divide, then now also you get 0.94. So it can be generally given as, x can be generally given as, x is equal to, the expression for x is ms divided by ms plus mw. That means this is ms, means mass of dry steam or saturated steam, mass of dry saturated steam or dry steam in a given sample of wet steam. This is mass of moisture or mass of water in a given sample, both in the same units. That is, they can be in grams or they can be in kgs, whatever unit you can give, you can give. This will give you, this expression gives you the dryness fraction. Now, whenever wet steam is given in a numerical, in a problem, whenever they give wet steam, they will give its pressure and dryness fraction. If dryness fraction and pressure are given, it means the steam that is given in the problem is wet steam. Next, after this comes total heat or enthalpy of steam. Seventh one, total heat, or it is also called as enthalpy of steam. Now, it means it is the quantity of heat or amount of heat absorbed by 1 kg water at 0 degree centigrade to reach its present state. In whatever state that steam is, whatever stage it is, to come to that stage, how much heat it has absorbed, starting from 1 kg water at 0 degree centigrade, that is known as the total heat or enthalpy of steam. It is denoted by H, capital H. If it is wet steam of any given pressure, if pressure and the dryness fraction of this wet steam is given, we can get the enthalpy using this formula, HF plus XHFG. That is, HF is sensible heat. It has taken all the sensible heat corresponding to its pressure. So we can get this value of HF from the steam table if we know the pressure. Now, plus a part of latent heat. What part of latent heat? If it is 94% dry, it is 94% of latent heat. If it is 90% dry, it is 90% of latent heat. If it is 95% wet, then it is 95% of latent heat. So many kilojoules per kg. These formulae will give you the value per kg only, because from the steam table, what you are getting is the values of HF and HFG is for 1 kg only, and it is for, if you start the heating from the 0 degree centigrade, and this formula will hold good. Now, if it is saturated steam, dry saturated steam, then it will be HF plus, now X will become 1, X will be 1, that is 100% dry. Steam is 100% dry, or it is dry saturated, so this will be HFG. You can directly take this value as HG. In your steam table, you have after HF, you have HFG, after HFG, you have one more column, HG, HF, HFG, next column is HG. Now, anywhere you add these two, the total will be HG only. That will be same as HG. So, if it is dry saturated steam, you can pick these separately and add also, or it is directly available in the steam table, you can pick it like that also. So many kilojoules per kg. If it is superheated steam, then it will be HG, that is this heat, that is HF plus HFG, directly we have picked up from here, plus Cp into T soup, that is T soup minus T sat, that is the heat of superheat given after this, so many kilojoules per kg. This formula will give you the total heat or enthalpy of wet, dry and superheated steam. So, these formula you have to know to do numericals. Next, after this comes external work of evaporation. External work of evaporation. Eighth, external work of evaporation or external work done during evaporation. During evaporation, it is, you can put it as W, its symbol as W, it is also given in kilojoules per kg. Now, what is this? See, evaporation is the process of converting matter in liquid state, from liquid state to gaseous state. Now, matter gives resistance to this conversion. Matter gives resistance to this conversion. It doesn't want to get converted in from one state to another state. It wants to remain in the same state. Now, in order to make it convert, we will have to do some work. Now, that work which is done is known as the work done during evaporation. Now, mathematically, this work done during evaporation is the product of pressure and specific volume. Pressure and specific volume. So, for wet steam, it is 100 PXVG. Now, this 100 P is the pressure. Pressure will be generally given in bars. In problems, they give it is in bars. Now, if I multiply this bar by 100, it gets converted into kilo pascals or kilo newton per square meter. So, to convert the pressure from bar to this thing, this 100 already it is there. This XVG is called the specific volume of wet steam. Specific, that is 1 kg wet steam at any given pressure and dryness fraction occupies a volume of XVG. The value of VG you can again get from the steam table if you know the pressure. There is a column in that VG column, from there you can get. So this will give you the work done during evaporation. In case of wet steam, you get W wet by this formula. If it is saturated steam, then it will be 100 PVG, because X becomes 1 here in the case of dry saturated steam. So, the specific volume is VG directly, and if it is superheated steam, it will be 100 P into VG. Now, the specific volume will be capital T soup divided by capital T sat. This capital means it should be in degree Kelvin. The value that we get from the steam table is in degree centigrade. You have to convert from degree centigrade to degree Kelvin by adding 273. If you add 273 to degree centigrade, it gets converted. Both this and this, both saturation temperature and superheated steam temperature must be in degree Kelvin in this formula. This is the specific volume of superheated steam. This is the specific volume. To get the volume of superheated steam per kg, we will use this formula. So this is so many kilojoules per kg again. So this is how the external work done during evaporation is calculated. Now the difference between actual latent heat and the external work done, that is actual latent heat absorbed by steam, any steam, minus external work done, during evaporation, this difference is called the internal latent heat. Internal latent heat of steam is defined as the difference between these two. This is the ninth property. Actual latent heat absorbed by 1 kg steam minus the amount of heat spent in doing work to overcome the resistance offered to formation of steam, that is called as internal latent heat. Next comes the internal energy of steam. It is denoted by either E or U is its symbol. It is the energy possessed by 1 kg of steam at any given pressure and condition. This is called as internal energy. This will be equal to sensible heat plus internal latent heat, or it can be given as total heat, that is enthalpy minus external work done. This way also it can be given. So U wet, internal energy of wet steam of given pressure and drainage fraction will be its total heat, that is HF plus XHFG. This is the total heat, minus work done during evaporation, that is 100 PXVG, so many kilojoules per kg. If it is dry saturated steam, then total heat or enthalpy is HG. This X becomes 1. So HG minus 100 PVG, so many kilojoules per kg. Then if it is superheated steam, then it will be HG plus CP into T sup minus T sat. Here they can be in degree centigrade. Small t, I am writing both as small t, they can be in degree centigrade, minus 100 PVG into, here it should be capital T, that is in degree Kelvin, T sup by T sat, capital T sup by T sat, so many kilojoules per kg. So this is the formula, these are the formulae for calculating internal energy of steam. This you will not get much problem here, lay internal latent heat, you will not get very big problems, but this is important. What is important is specific volume of steam, enthalpy of steam, and internal energy of steam. Next comes the entropy of steam. Next, 11th one is entropy of steam. It is denoted by S, or some books give it as phi also. Now, this is the symbol. Its unit is kilojoule per kg degree Kelvin. Now it is not very easy to define entropy like we define the other things. It is not easy to define entropy. Entropy is defined as a thermodynamic property of steam which increases, or property of a working substance which increases when it absorbs heat and it decreases when it rejects heat. Now change in entropy, delta S will be equal to delta H, that is change in enthalpy divided by change in absolute temperature. This is the definition of change in entropy. Now we can get the entropy from first principles, from basics, for wet steam, dry steam, superheated steam like this. S wet will be equal to log of SW into log of T sat by 273 to base E plus X into HFG divided by capital T sat, so many kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. If we use this formula, then we say it has been done with from first principles. SW, that is specific heat of water, into log of T sat by 273 to base E plus HFG divided by T sat, so many kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. If it is superheated steam, then it will be SW into log of T sat by 273 to base E plus HFG divided by capital T sat plus Cp, means specific heat of superheated steam at constant pressure, multiplied by log of T sup, capital T sup, by capital T sat to base E, so many kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. If you do by these formula, then it is said to be calculated on the basis of from first principle. Now this SW is specific heat of water, its value approximately is 4.2 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. It is 4.187, something like that. You can take it as 4.2. Now this value is directly available from the steam tables. If you know the pressure, this is available as it is available as SF from the steam table. Again, it depends upon the pressure. For any given pressure, you can get its value. And this value is called as SFG. So X, SF plus X into SFG, you can do it like this. Now this entire value, this is SF, this is SFG, this entire value can be directly taken under SG. There is a column under SG where you can take it. This whole thing will be covered in that. Now this will be SG, that is this value is SG, this whole value is SG corresponding to that pressure, plus this, of course you will have to do it like this only, Cp into log of capital T sup by capital T sat to base E. So these are the formulae. If they ask you to do it from first principle only, you have to do this. Otherwise, in other problems, we will do by these only. These values you can directly get, instead of calculating them, you can directly get from the steam tables. So these are the different properties of steam which we have to know.